Let's imagine you have a pile of books and you want to organize them alphabetically. How would you do that? You can pick up the top book from the pile and put it on the shelf. Then pick up the next one and decide if you have to put it before the first book or after that. Every time you can pick up one book and put it in the correct place among the books on the shelf and continue up to the point that no books remain in the pile. This is called insertion sort. The same idea can be applied to an array of numbers. We virtually divide the array into two sections, sorted and unsorted. Every time we pick the first value of the unsorted section and insert it at the correct position in the sorted part. And that's why we call it insertion sort. If the position of the value is occupied by another value, we have to shift some values to the right and make a space for the new element. Here, the first value of the unsorted section is 6, and its correct position is occupied by 14. So we need to shift the 14 and 19 to the right and make a space for 6. We do it over and over, and each time it increases the length of the sorted section and reduces the length of the unsorted part. At the end, we place the last item of the array in the correct position, and our array becomes fully sorted. Now, let's write the code of this algorithm. Initially, we know an array with only a single item is always sorted. So we assume the first item of the array is in the sorted section. We start to iterate from the second item to the last item over the array. This is where we pick the element that we want to insert in the right position in the sorted section. Let's copy the value of the current item to the key. We want to compare the key to the items in the sorted section and find the correct position for it. It needs another loop that starts from the last item of the sorted section and goes until the first one. Every time we find an item in the sorted part that's greater than the key, we shift that item one to the right. So we make space for the key. Finally, when we find the correct position for the key item, we copy it to that index. If it doesn't make sense, don't worry. We will see the run of it on an array in a moment. But before that, let's see if we can rewrite this code with a few lines. We can combine the internal loop and the if conditions together and come up with a new one-liner condition. It looks better, doesn't it? Okay, let's see how it works on an array of 6. Our assumption was that the first item is sorted, so we consider 14 to be at the correct position and start iterating from the second item with index 1 to the last item. We copy the value of the second item to the key. Now we have to iterate over the sorted section which only has one item. We compare 14 with the key which is 1, and as 14 is greater, we copy its value to index 1 and decrease j. As j is less than 0, the next evaluation of the while condition is false. So we copy the key to the index 0. As you can see, 1 and 14 are in order. Let's do it one more time. Increase I and set it to 2. Copy the value of index 2 to the key, so the key becomes 6. And start to iterate on the sorted section. 14 is greater than 6, so we copy it to the right and decrease j. 1 is not greater than 6, so it exits the while and copies the key to the index 1. Now 1, 6, and 14 are in order. We continue this until inserting the last item in its correct position. Let's count the required number of comparisons and name it Tn. If an array is already sorted, on each iteration we only need to compare an item with one item. So this case requires n-1 comparisons, which is in the order of n. The worst case is when an array is in a reverse order. This time we have to compare each item to all items before it, which is in the order of n squared. Insertion sort is actually efficient for small arrays, but when it comes to bigger ones, it would become quite an inefficient algorithm. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please like it. And if you are interested in similar content, please consider subscribing to the channel.